Man, that is quick.
Gato camera support.
What?
The EOS RP's listed, not the EOS R. Why is that not listed on here?
Is there some kind of conspiracy going on here?
EOS R not listed on your camera check list. Quick disclaimer, there will be Amazon affiliate links down below. If you were to click on them, make a purchase through those links,
I'll get a small percentage of your money. I'd really appreciate it. Let's go.
Hey, finally, a Canon camera that can do clean HDMI out, unlimited record time, 4K with dual pixel autofocus. Let's take a look at the Canon EOS R, baby. Let's do it. Okay, let's connect the Canon EOS R to the Elgato Cam Link 4K. Now you should have the Canon EOS R. If not, that might be a problem. And then we got the actual Elgato Cam Link 4K itself, and then we'll need a cord to connect it to. Mini HDMI to an HDMI cable will work. HDMI in goes into the Elgato Cam Link 4K. Mini HDMI in will actually plug into the camera. And then the Elgato Cam Link will plug into a USB 3 port that's marked blue. Okay, if you haven't already, we need to switch the camera over to video mode. So on the top of the camera, push the mode button. Then on the back of the camera, press the info button. You'll want to navigate over to the manual video mode. Press OK. We're in video mode. All right, now the fun begins. Let's dive into the settings to get this set up. So on the camera, let's go ahead and push that menu button. The first setting we're going to play around with, navigate over to the wrench icon. And on page 2, we're going to turn eco mode off. Your power saving, I have it set to 30 minutes. It's not really that big of a deal. That's just your display setting. But just in case, just go ahead and set it to 30 minutes. Next, for the auto power off, we're going to set that to disable. This setting does matter, so make sure that is set to disable. And third and lastly, for this setting, the viewfinder, set this to whatever. I have it set to off. All right, next up for our setting is equally important as the power off. This is to get clean HDMI out. So let's navigate over to the camera icon, and on page 4, scroll on down to HDMI display, select that, and then we're going to select the camera plus monitor or display, which whenever it is. That one is required, so make sure that one is set, and that's really it for that setting. Moving on. Okay, for our third menu option here, I have it marked as required. Not really that important, but I've marked it as required because we're going to utilize the eye detection autofocus. But let's go ahead and jump into that. Go ahead and navigate over to the AF icon. It should be right next to the camera icon, just to the right of it. Navigate to that, and then we're going to be on page 1 and scroll down to eye detection autofocus. If that is grayed out, make sure you have face tracking autofocus selected or enabled. Once you have that, then the eye detection autofocus should be selectable. Once you're able to select that, go ahead and enable that. And below that, I have it marked as required. That is the movie servo autofocus. We want to enable that because that's going to keep subjects in focus without the camera actually recording. So go ahead and turn that on. Turn her on. Moving on. All right, if you guys stuck around long enough through the video, I appreciate it. Thank you guys. I'll try and wrap this up as quickly as possible. Some quick tips, advice, and some Q&A that I got here in my notes that I thought would be sort of important to throw out here on the video just in case. Tip number 1, make sure your FPS in camera matches with the FPS to whatever recording or streaming platform that you're using. In my case, I'm using OBS, Open Broadcast Software. I just make sure, you know, those frames per second match up. Just make sure it matches up. Moving on. Elgato Cam Link 4K can do max 30 frames per second in 4K or UHD or 1080p or full HD. It's 60 frames per second. Second tip, utilize the face and eye autofocus. It's awesome. Q&A here. Will my camera stop recording after 30 minutes? No. The Canon EOS R is capable of doing unlimited record time, so long as you have a power source. If you're going to be doing long live streams or recordings, you might want to look into purchasing a dummy battery. I found one on Amazon with the most reviews, and it had 4 stars, but put an affiliate link down below if you want to check it out. It's up to you. I haven't used one personally, so I would do your research on it. And does the Canon EOS R support autofocus? You guys already know that. Yes, it does. 4K dual pixel autofocus. Yes! And then lastly, recommended tools, Canon EOS R dummy battery, mini HDMI to HDMI. Actually, I have several cords. And the 1.8 4K crop on the Canon EOS R bothers you. You might want to look into picking up the Metabone speed booster, the EF to RF speed booster. That'll reduce the 4K crop from 1.8 to 1.2. Also, I have my show note available on my website. They're kind of goofy, but tips, troubleshooting issues I ran into, Q&A, and then recommended tools with affiliate link. But that's available to download for free. I use Shopify. Once you put all your information in, it'll just instantly send you a link to download the PDF. It'll be there. It's there if you want it. Cool. That is the video, guys. Thank you for watching. If you stuck around this long, I hope I covered everything. I will see you in the next video. If this video helps you out, please give it a like, and I'd really like a subscribe too. I'd like to get to 100 subscribers. That'd be awesome.